For the past, like, decade, Rainmaker Studios has been talking about a reboot, and it's finally come to life, thanks in part to Netflix. If you've never heard of Reboot, the original series revolved around the sprites that lived inside a computer and their interaction with the user through the various games they played. It started off as a real kind of standard cartoony gimmicky show. Then, towards the end of season 2, the series turned into a hardcore drama that sucked you in. And the original Reboot series is still the most creative, original thing I've ever experienced. I would easily rank it as the best animated children's series ever created. Seriously, my son is named Archer Matrix after Enzo Matrix in this series. I also painted a frisket on my wall as a teenager, had a cat named Enzo, and somewhere around here I have my AndrAIa action figure still sealed in the box. This show is why I studied 3D animation and film in college. If you haven't seen it yet, go buy the DVD set. It's really that good. And now, Netflix has Reboot the Guardian Code, or TGC, from here on out. And, I don't want to say bad things about it. It's a perfectly legitimate show aimed at tweens, and it does get better with each episode, but I had hoped for more as a mega fan of this series. I get I'm not the target audience, but a lot of shows aimed at kids write the scripts for adults, like Gravity Falls and the original Reboot series.
No, I can't.
And producing shows for kids that are actually aimed at adults too ends up entertaining way more people and gives parents and kids something to do together. And TGC, well, I'll put it this way. It is a hugely missed opportunity to make these new kids guardians instead of moving Bob, Enzo, Dot, Mouse, Ray Tracer, and the others to internet gaming. I mean, Ray is a search engine already, so he could have taken them all to an MMORPG or something, couldn't he? I don't understand why they called this Reboot when it's more like VR Troopers. But my goal with this channel is to make things better and or more interesting. So my job here is to try and reconcile these differences, not to complain. I mean, hey, they got Kathleen Barr back to voice Dot, so fan service isn't totally dead in TGC. So to get to my theory, the original Reboot series ended after 3 seasons in, I think, 1997. And after it ended, fans harassed Rainmaker Studios, which used to be called Mainframe Entertainment Inc., Mainframe, like the sprite's habitat in the original series. Anyways, fans couldn't get enough Reboot and begged for more, and in 2001 we got 2 miniseries / movies, Damon Rising, which was incredibly good, and My Two Bobs, which ended on the cliffhanger of Megabyte taking over Mainframe. That was it! That's all we got! There were no other episodes made, and I always wondered if My Two Bobs was supposed to lead into a full season 4, or if that cliffhanger was punishment for fans endlessly whining for more episodes. Either way, it hurt, man. That kept me up at night, and I was like 16 at the time. Now, in Reboot TGC, Megabyte is pulled out of Mainframe into the internet by our largely mysterious hacker antagonist called the Sorcerer. At least Rainmaker has not lost the quality of their dad puns. And for some reason, the Sorcerer sought out and released Megabyte from a 20-plus-year-old computer system. Why? Couldn't you make something just as powerful? I mean, I'm pretty confident that Damon was more powerful than Megabyte, so why would you bother salvaging an ancient virus that probably isn't even compatible with today's technology? I mean, I know Megabyte evolved into a Trojan horse virus by the end of the series, but I mean, is that really such a big whoo that we need that again in 2018? Aren't there more disruptive things by now? Well, what if the original series stopped short because the truth was just too awful? What if the fact of the matter is that Megabyte, now supercharged and overpowered, decimated Mainframe to the point that the user had to abandon his or her computer just to stop the virus? Or, as is implied in TGC, the computer Mainframe actually belonged to a high school, so they had to power it down and replace it. And so all the sprites within it effectively died. Well, okay, maybe not all, because Ray Tracer, Mouse, Matrix, AndrAIa, and Frisket could effectively jump in a game game or an internet portal and get out of Dodge, which would cover why none of those characters appear in the season finale of TGC. And if you're fuzzy on your old Reboot details, the gimmick was that if you went into a game and won, you came back out just fine, but if you lost, you got nullified unless you could convert your icon to make the system think you were a gaming AI, in which case you could use that icon and just keep jumping from game to game to game to game. And from the games, you could eventually get to the internet and go to a different system if you wanted to. To the same effect, Mouse and Ray Tracer were sort of outsiders from the internet to begin with, so they could go back at any time. Like I said, Ray Tracer was a search engine and Mouse was a hacker program, so they weren't forced to stay anywhere. But also remember that the sprites live in time increments where a second is comparable to a day because they process things much faster than humans do. So sprites age faster and thereby become old and obsolete faster, meaning any sprites who left Mainframe over 20 years ago probably don't exist any longer. And well, that sucks. But the season 3 finale of Reboot showed that the sprites can also be refreshed by rebooting the computer, and any missing code will be replaced, thusly explaining why a young Enzo was regenerated while the grown Matrix had his icon on gaming mode. So even though Mainframe was demolished by Megabyte and everyone basically died, all is not lost. Because when they turned the Mainframe back on in TGC, they effectively turned back on Mainframe the city and rebooted Bob, Dot, and Little Enzo. Unfortunately, the Binomes and other characters besides the Key 3 had already had their code corrupted by Megabyte and could not be salvaged and rebooted. A moment of silence for our fallen friends. So, while the Guardian Code isn't the perfect translation for a modern Reboot series, I can see that they're trying, and we can hope that the creators will listen to the fanbase and take notes to improve Season 2. By the way, if you're listening, Rainmaker, I am totally available for a long-distance writing or consulting job. It might not be reality, but theories are more fun! Well, that's all I have for now, but this video's not quite over yet. I get a lot of comments that say, do a theory on this topic, but I've already done those theories. So please consider going to my main channel page and clicking on the video tab so that way you can see everything I've done. You will probably find a lot of things you like that you never even knew that I posted. I want to let you know that I also have two other channels, Say Halo Goodbye Gaming and the Fanily Family Vlogs. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed enough to hit subscribe and share. I can use all the help I can get to let other people know that this channel exists. And if you made it this far, leave me a comment that says something like, hey, I made it to the end! And then let me know what kind of videos you want to see in the future. I can't make any promises, but the more people that request something, the more I can look into it. Okay, well, I love you. I'll see you in the next video!